Hello! Good day, class! I am Sir Niljan Abitria, and in this video, we are going to learn how to represent real-life situations using piecewise functions. In our last lesson, we already introduced what is relation and function, and how do we determine easily functions from mere relations. And also, we already know that relations and functions can be represented by using ordered pairs, graph, table of values, and mapping diagram. In order to understand our lesson for today, let us define first what is piecewise function. A piecewise function is a function that contains several expressions depending on restriction of values the unknown variable will take on in a certain situation. So what does it mean? So ito yung pagbuo natin ng iba't ibang expressions na makakatulong sa atin para ma-meet natin ang iba't ibang kondisyon. So later on, magpapakita tayo ng mga example para sa piecewise function. But before we proceed, let us know what are the variables that involve in a piecewise functions in order to really understand how the piecewise function works. So first, let us define independent variable. Independent variable is a variable often denoted by x whose variation does not depend on that of another. So it is like an independent person. Independent variables are changed by choice. You can pick what value they will be. Unlike to dependent variable. Dependent variable is a variable often denoted by y, whose value depends on that of another. So it's like an dependent person. For example, a child depends or needs their parents. Dependent variables are changed because of another variable. So now, how do you identify independent and dependent variables? So here are some tips. In independent variable, you just simply ask yourself, can I choose a value for this variable? If so, so be it. Unlike to dependent variable, so you just simply ask yourself, does this value change because of another value? If yes, so be it. So you just simply complete this sentence. The dependent variable changes because of the independent variable. That's it. So let's apply it for some example. The more your dog eats, the more your dog weighs. In this situation, we need to know what is changing because of something. Is it weight changing because of eating or eating changing because of the weight? Obviously, the correct analysis here is that weight's changing because of eating. So we can say that the weight is our dependent variable and our independent variable is foods or eating. Because dependent variable changes because of the independent variable. Did you get it, class? Okay, next example. Your height and your age. Is it height changing because of age or age changing because of your height? So obviously, our dependent variable is the height and our independent variable is age. Because dependent variable changes because of the independent variable. Did you get it, class? So let's apply it to the real life situation using piecewise functions. So number one, a user is charged 200 pesos weekly for a particular mobile plan, which include 50 free text messages. Text messages in excess of 50 are charged 1 peso each. Represent the weekly cost for text messaging using the function T of M, where M is the number of text messages sent in a month. So first, we need to find what are the variables here. And our variables here are cost for mobile phone and excess in text messages. And secondly, we need to identify where is independent variable and dependent variable. So let us apply it in the sentence. Is it cost changing because of the excess or excess changing because of the cost? So obviously, the correct analysis here is that the cost change because of the excess. you just simply always put the variables into the sentence. That dependent variable changes because of the independent variable. Did you get it, class? To put it into the piecewise function, class, here are you going to do. We already know that the cost of the text messages is our dependent variable. So based on the illustration, you will be charged 200 pesos if the number of the text messages is less than or equal to only 50 text messages. That is the first condition. The second one is you will be charged 200 pesos plus the cost of the excess per text messages if the text messages is greater than 50 text messages. That is how you will express function using piecewise function. So let's take a look for another example. A jeepney ride costs 7 pesos for the first 1,000 meters, and each additional integer kilometer adds 2.5 pesos to the fare. By using a piecewise function, represent the jeepney fare in terms of the distance d in meters. You already know how you will identify what is dependent and independent variable. So now, to express it into the piecewise function, it looks like this. Let d be the distance in meters, and f of d represent the jeepney fare. So that is our dependent variable as a function of distance. So you will be charged 7 pesos if the distance is less than or equal to 1,400 meters only. And if the distance is greater than 1,400 meters, you will be charged 7 pesos plus 2.5 pesos for the excess distance in meters. Did you follow me, class? Okay, so that is how you will be able to express function in the real-life situation using piecewise function. So let's take for one more example. A jeepney ride costs 8 pesos for the first 4 kilometers, and each additional integer kilometers adds 1.5 pesos to the fare. Use a piecewise function to represent the jeepney fare in terms of the distance d in kilometers. So here are you going to do. So let d be the distance in meters, and f of d represent the jeepney fare as a function of distance. And to express it to the piecewise function, f of d is equal to 8 pesos if the distance is less than or equal to 4. And if the distance is greater than 4, you will be charged 8 pesos plus 1.5 pesos multiplied by the excess distance in meters. Did you get it, class? Okay, how about its graph? So let us see how piecewise functions are plotted in the Cartesian coordinate plane. So it looks like this. So here is an example on plotting the graph of piecewise functions. As you observe, notice that the changes focus around the x value of 1 and negative 1. Hint: when graphing, focus on where the changes in the graph occur. From x value of the negative infinity to negative 1, the graph is a straight line as you observe. And from x value of negative 1 to positive 1, the graph is constant, right? And from x values of 1 to positive infinity, the graph is quadratic. That is a part of parabola. Are you still there? Okay, thank you, class, for staying. So now, can you still recall the piecewise function that represents the jeepney fare in our example number 3? Okay, very good. So let us try to plot it on the Cartesian coordinate plane. So f of d is equal to 8 pesos if the distance is less than or equal to 4. And you will be charged 8 pesos plus 1.5 pesos multiplied by the excess distance in meter if the distance is greater than 4. So, in plotting the graph of piecewise functions, consider each part or piece. So, the first piece is f of d is equal to 8 if the distance is less than or equal to 4. So, try to plot this on the plane first. Then, for f of d is equal to 8
plus 1.5 multiplied by the distance in meter if the distance is greater than 4. Okay, class? So make a table, then plot the corresponding points on the graph. So try it, class. So now, let's have an exercise on how to express real-life situation in a piecewise functions. Are you ready, class? So letter A. A taxi ride costs 50 pesos for the first 600 meters, and each additional meter, or a fraction thereof, adds 0.50 to the fare. Use the piecewise function to signify the taxi fare in terms of the distance d in meters. What is the independent variable here in this illustration? Yes, meters traveled by the taxi. How about the dependent variable? Yes, the taxi fare. How about to express it to the piecewise function? So you just simply write like this. F of d is equal to 50 if the distance is less than or equal to 600. Or, if the distance is greater than 600, the function is 50 plus the excess distance minus 600 meters multiplied by 0.50. Did you get it, class? So how about this? Pet grooming in your favorite vet clinic is charged according to your dog's weight. If your dog is 10 kilos in under, the groomer charges 100 pesos. And if your dog is between 10 and up to 15 kilos, she charges 150. And if your dog is more than 15 kilos, she charges 200 pesos plus an additional 2 pesos for each excess kilo more than 15 kilos. Write a piecewise function to signify the grooming charge in terms of the weight, in kilos or k, of your dog. So here, what is the independent variable? Yes, the weight of the dog. How about the dependent variable? Very good, the grooming charge. So we can say that the dependent variable changes because of the independent variable. So how about to express it into the piecewise functions? You can write it like this. F of k is equal to 100 if k is less than or equal to 10. And 150 if your kilos of your dog is in between 10 and 15. And if the weight of your dog is greater than or more than 15 kilos, you will be charged 200 pesos plus k minus 15 multiplied by 2 pesos in every excess kilo more than 15 kilos. That's all for today's video. I hope you've learned about piecewise function. Thank you for the time. Thank you for watching, class.